morning, EVHS, and happy Friday.
We hope you had a great spring break and great week back at school.
It's with sad hearts that we are letting you all know that is the very last episode of Pointer Pack News. We just don't want to do it anymore. So enjoy the last episode ever!
Here's your Pointer Pack News episode 106.
All jokes aside, let's kick you off with some VBHS news.
First up, a big congrats to the VBHS Pointer Quiz Bowl.
The team brought home the fourth place trophy and will be advancing to state on April 9th.
And more congratulations to our fellow pointers who went to the State Technology Student Association competition in Hot Springs and represented VBHS once again in a big way. Here's a list of all the winners.
Proud of all of our TSA students who prepared and competed. Way to go, pointers!
Many of these students qualified to compete at the National TSA Competition in Dallas, Texas this summer.
If you'd be interested in knowing how you might help sponsor one or a few of these students to make the trip to Nationals, please contact Dr. Joe McLean at joe.mclean@vbsd.us.
Seniors, cap and gowns get delivered today, and be sure to put it on your calendar that we are taking pictures next Wednesday, April 6th from 9 till noon. If you haven't gotten them yet, please get in touch with Mrs. S. Moore and or the counseling office.
Just a few more things for VBHS News. You've heard it all this week, but keep the crop tops at home.
The ACT is tomorrow, so good luck. And if you're still needing a refund for not going to the homecoming dance, be sure to see Ms. Hammond by 3 today.
Now, here's your VBHS sports.
Welcome back to sports.
Baseball went 2-2 in their tournament in Gulf Shores over the break.
They played a doubleheader in Greenwood Tuesday and traveled to Worcester yesterday.
Next week, baseball hosts Mountain Home Tuesday for a doubleheader and hosts Shiloh Christian Friday.
Softball hosted Ozark on Monday and traveled to Greenwood Tuesday.
Tonight and tomorrow, softball hosts the River City Rumble at the Field of Dreams.
Track girls were champions of the Greenwood Invitational and the boys were runner-ups.
Chris Russell placed first in triple jump.
Elizabeth Yancey placed first in discus.
Girls 4x100 relay placed first.
Jordan Perryman placed first in triple jump.
Lastly, Grayson Burgett placed first in long jump.
The track team traveled to Salem Springs yesterday.
Boys soccer is currently 3-0 in conference and girls are 2-1 in conference.
They traveled to Alma Tuesday and host Bologna tonight.
That's it for sports this week.
See you next week.
It's been a while since we have given you any updates, so here are some of the major headlines.
Russia has intensified its attacks on a few vulnerable cities, including Mariupol and Chernihiv, in which some believe is an attempt to split Ukraine.
But around Kyiv, Russia is withdrawing some of its troops to regroup in Belarus.
Poland has accepted the most refugees by far, about 2.2 million according to the UN. Next on the list are Romania and Hungary, each between 300,000 and 600,000.
Western leaders distance themselves from President Biden's ad-libbed remark that Vladimir Putin cannot remain in power. Many fear Putin may expand the war if he thinks the West is seeking regime change in Russia.
If you want a deeper look at any of this, we have links posted below of the full stories. Bonus, there's a Washington Post article that published children's drawings of the war.
President Biden, in a passionate speech from Warsaw last Saturday, proclaimed the West's complete support of Ukraine. "We stand with you, period," Biden said.
The next day, Ukraine's president offered a different message. He criticized the West for not doing enough in a videotaped speech to Ukrainians. He contrasted their determination, heroism, and firmness with the lack of courage from the West that had refused to send jets and tanks to Ukraine.
"The war has cost Ukraine almost $565 billion, including more than 4,900 miles of damaged or destroyed railways," its economy minister said.
More in the U.S. Here's President Biden's 2023 wish list. The $5.8 trillion budget calls for increased defense spending and an additional $32 billion to fight crime. Biden promised to fund the police during the last State of the Union. It would also seek to reduce the national deficit by $1 trillion over 10 years through higher taxes on billionaires and corporations. The White House's budget is not a binding document, but a blueprint that signals the administration priorities to Congress.
More in the world. Israel hosted a summit with four Arab countries and the U.S.
a sign of a realignment among Middle Eastern powers driven by fears of a nuclear Iran.
Speaking of Israel, a Palestinian gunman killed 5 people outside Tel Aviv, the 5th attack in Israel in 2 weeks.
Gangs in El Salvador killed at least 62 people, gunning down anyone on the street.
An ice shelf collapsed in eastern Antarctica for the first time since satellites began observing the continent nearly half a century ago. Remember the COVID lockdowns? They're still happening.
China is attempting its biggest citywide lockdown since the pandemic began. It'll lock down the financial hub of Shanghai, population 25 million, in 2 different stages over 9 days to allow for mass COVID testing.
Our thoughts are with beloved Foo Fighter drummer Taylor Hawkins, who was in Colombia in the band's world tour when he died at 50 at Hotel Bugatta.
Oh, and last but not least, Will Smith apologized to Chris Rock for slapping him at the Oscars. "I was out of line and I was wrong," he wrote.
So now we can all stop talking about the slap.
Hey, it's Hadley. Let me tell you about your weekend weather. Aside from a little rain, it's been a beautiful, warm week. Today looks fairly humid with a high of 60 degrees and a low of 46. Tomorrow it looks a little warmer with a high of 70 and a slight wind up to 10 miles per hour. As the day goes on, the clouds will blow away and it will be a starry evening. Into Sunday, the clouds will return and temperatures will continue to gradually rise. Other than that, it's going to be fairly humid with a little bit of wind. Now for your world weather, I don't feel like doing world weather anymore, so you can consider this my resignation.
That's it for this week. Thanks for tuning in. Make sure to check out the links below for a bigger scoop on these stories. We'll see you again next week. Until then, drink some water, wear your seatbelts, tell somebody you love them. Make sure to be sending us your student subs. Here are some from spring break.
I'm off on the adventure.
We're good. This is dedicated to all the kids like me.
Wherever you are.